In this session, we will learn how to create metrics. What are metrics? They're nothing but a quantitative assessment which will help us make decisions. If you remember Pinalis' shopping cart, it had three items. Number one, working preference of people between work from home and working from office. Number two, percentage of overall sick leave to understand to monitor employee wellness. And the third one was learning Power BI basics through this project. See, I think she's already doing that just like you. The first two items in her shopping cart are nothing but metrics, also called as measures in the Power BI context. The first metric you will learn to create is the percentage of work from home. The second one is the percentage of sick leave. But there are more. You will see that during the process, how a data analyst can add more value by helping the stakeholders to discover more metrics.
All right, so since we got the data in the table now, we're going to create the measures that we want to see in the dashboard. Okay, I would recommend to keep the measures in a separate table. So I'm going to call this like a measure table.
Just to summarize, Eman, click on that enter data button on the home tab, and he's just entering the data manually.
Yeah.
Okay.
So first of all, I want to, the whole thing is revolving around the fact it's about a percentage. So where we have the ratio to the total working days, the number of present days versus total working days, number of absent days versus total working days, number of work from home versus present days. So the first thing I need to know is the total working days. So I'm going to create a new measure. And the total working days should be count. It should be the count of all the values, right? Basically, all the things you have in the value. But if I simply do the count, I think it is just giving the total days. But I think we need to take out the weekly off, holiday off. From this. So apart from this, everything is a working day. Okay. So I'm going to go back to my Power BI. I'm going to make this total days. This is total days. I'm going to create a variable. I'm calling this as a variable. And I'm creating a second variable, which is like non-working days. Non-work days. And so this is again going to be the count of the values. But in this, we need to remove
Can you increase the font size, Emanan? Maybe controls
yes.
Scroll up. Yeah.
Oh yeah, that's a good idea. I'm just finding the non-work days, which is, I forgot it again. What is the code? It's WO and HO. Okay. So this formula basically is saying, count only the values which has WO and HO. And so finally, when you're working on this stuff like this, you need to understand how the calculate function works. That's very important. Like if you understand how the calculate function works, you can do 80% of your work.
Right.
Okay. I'm going to return the final value, which is going to be total days minus non-work days.
So folks, that line number five, can you open that again? So line number five is more like SQL's where query, where you are saying, get me count of final data value, where final data is either WO or HO. It is, if you know Excel, SQL a little bit, it is sort of like that. That inner portion is like SQL where query.
Yes, that's right. Okay. So if you just drag this, all you have to do is like just drag it to the canvas here, and it will try to build a measure. So you have the total working days, which means, you know, the total working days for all the employees in this 4 months, right? It's like the total sum. And from the total working days, I want to understand what do we need to do? I think we need to understand the present days, the number of days the people are present, correct?
Yes.
So I'm going to call it present days. And this is going to be quite simple. Use the same formula that we used before. Calculate the count of value. But I want the values only in... I think I saw it's P, right? Present days is P, correct?
Yes, P.
Okay. Okay, let me think about it. So if I add the present days... So we also have work from home days, right? Work from home is considered as present.
Yes.
Okay. And we also have half work from home.
Yes. If the employee is doing half day work from home, that's all considered in present.
Yeah. So I cannot use this formula because it will consider half work from home also as one. It's not the full working day. So we need to do something different. Let me do it. So, but let me just add it as a,
But Heman, you're trying to do present versus not present. So our definition of present is even if person is working half at home, half in the office.
Yes.
For that day, the person is present. So present, yes.
Fully present.
One, yes.
Yes.
Yeah. So let's say if they are working only half work from home, right? And let's say if they take half sick leave.
Okay.
So that is like half day present, right?
Hmm.
So we need that is half day present. Like yes.
Yeah.
Hmm.
So if I just add it here, it will consider as full day present. So I have to be very clear in saying that. Just give me, just calculate the present days. Where the value is equal to P. But this formula is not complete. We also need to add the work from home days to this. Present days. Okay. So since so if I use the same approach here, so what it does is like it calculates, it counts each value as one. So if there is P, it is one. If there is a second P, there is two. If I use the same approach here, there is no way to say here, like if there is half work from home, calculate this as half. We can do this in DAX, but it will become very complex. So if we can do this in a DAX measure, but it will become very complex. So what I will do is like, I'm thinking to create it directly in this table. I think that will be easier for me. I go to the final data table. I will create it here. So here I can easily say if it is work from home, write one. If it is half work from home, write 0.5. Then as a column, to me to do the summation on that column, it will be easier. So I'm going to create a new column saying here and call this work from home count. And this is going to be, I can use a simple if statement. If value if this value is equal to P, if this value is equal to work from home, then it's one. Okay, so this is why I prefer to use switch statement, because I don't like writing multiple ifs. So I will rather write a switch statement. So which is a good alternative to if. And if it is half work from home, should be 0.5. And for all the rest of the values, let's sub zero. Is it correct by definition? Should we do this?
Yes.
So you can see for present, it's not considered as work from home. So it's zero.
Okay.
But when you see, let's do a quick check if my formula is working correct. So when I have half work from home, yeah, you can see it's 0.5.
Okay.
And when I have work from home, it will be 1. Perfect. That's what I need. So I'm going to create a new measure here, calling work from home. So now this is an easy measure. All you have to do is like just make a sum of the work from home count column. And like I said, I need to adjust my present base formula. And just adding, or I don't need to create a variable. Since I already created a measure, I don't need the variable. I'm simply adding the work from home count here. Okay, so I'm just pulling the present days here. So this kind of looks correct because, of course, your present day should be less than your working days, which looks quite correct to me. And I already have the first thing that you got that you want, which is do you want to call it presence percentage?
Yeah,
this should be, yeah, nothing but your present days divided by total working days. And since this is a percentage, I'm making this a percentage. So you can, Pinal, you can think this as an Excel formula, how you write an Excel formula, like sum, max, and all those things. You just have to learn the basic functions. It will help you. So once you practice this on your own, you will have a better understanding. So this is our overall, you know, presence percentage that we have got. And to kind of visualize things better, I'm going to add this slicer and drop the date column. So this is a date column. Okay, this is the reason. So you see that we have all these days, date as days, like each day. So I cannot select, I can select for each day, but let's say I want it as a month.
Mm.
Right? So I'm going to create a new column here as a date month. So I'm going to call this format date value. I'm going to say start of the month, date value. So this kind of gives me the start of the month. And I just go to the format here and say MMMYY. So I get this like short format. So instead of dropping the date now, I'll drop the month. Okay. Then you can change it to horizontal so you can have it like this. So you can select now for April and then see the presence percentage. You can select for May and see the presence percentage and then the June. So this forms, you know, the basic measures that we will use. And I think the next step is to build a dashboard out of this, you know, and we can build some measures on the fly because we have got the basic measures and we can build some measures on the fly as needed for the dashboard.
I hope you had a good introduction to creating DAX measures in Power BI. There are a few takeaways from this session. Number one is group your measures under one place. The second one is understanding calculate function in DAX is very important. And the last one, you can also create additional columns to your data using DAX. I'm excited for the next session. And yes, we will be building the dashboard in under 30 minutes. See you there.